I think last year when they launched the Epic Gyro, probably the question the designer Alan Hotter was asked the most was, why haven't you put the jailbreak bars in the fairway woods? Well, now with the Rogue fairways, they managed to get those two bars into the head, and that is there really to stiffen the structure of the head in order to attach the crown to the sole, and that allows the face to flex a little bit more. That is no mean achievement technically, because the bars are actually cast into the head. This is a stainless steel head with a carbon crown at the back. And they've also had to change the way the face cup is designed as well. And that's the structure that goes around the front of the club in order to hold the face in place and make it a little bit different in order to accommodate the bars. There's two models, there's a standard and a sub-zero model. I've got the standard model here, and when you put it down as a dress, it's got a lovely rounded look, which a lot of Callaway fairways do. And you can see the back of this carbon crown, and that is there to save weight, to sort of drop the center of gravity a little bit, because it will allow you to launch the club a little bit easier as well. There's no adjustable hosel on this one either, which there was on the previous Epic fairway. But I think it looks pretty good actually, so let's see how it goes. And you can hear the sort of carbon in the sound there, but I do think it's a very good sound overall. It's a lovely solid sound. The feel is very good indeed, and the flight was excellent as well. And this is a club that's really aimed at getting a ball up in the air. I had this on GC2 against the previous Epic fairway, and you can see that I was getting about an extra 1,000 RPM of spin. So it was a very different flight, even though actually the end result was very much the same. So it's really going to come down to what type of player you are, what you're going to want out of your fairway, whether you need one that just is kind of point and shoot, or whether you need the adjustability that Epic fairway gives it. I think with the Rogue, it's just got a bit more life to it than I think the Epic did. You know, it's just a lot easier to get up in the air, whereas the Epic was a nice fairway, but it didn't have any sort of pizzazz to it. It was very good for people who are high speed or high spin players, because it didn't knock that spin off. But I think if you're hitting it from the deck, then you'll find it quite difficult to get going. However, if you still need to maybe take some of the spin off, there is another option in the Rogue range I mentioned earlier, which is the Rogue Sub-Zero. So the difference between this and the standard model is it's got a slightly more compact head, but the weight, which is only 2 grams though, so it's not a big deal, which was in the back of the club, is now in the front. And that brings the CG a little bit closer to the front of the club, should mean that you're gonna get a slightly different trajectory and a different level of spin. So let's see how it goes. And just with that smaller head, you're getting a slightly more solid sound, probably more you might expect from a fairway wood. But for me, again, on GC2, the numbers were very similar again. I was getting a little bit more spin, but I was getting a lower launch and a slightly lower peak height as well. So really what you were seeing was some different flight characteristics, but it's actually quite subtle. And you know, a lot of this could be explained by maybe a slightly different swing or maybe a slightly different setup. So it would be a question of getting the right loft and the right style of head in order to suit you. However, the big difference came is when you started to tee these clubs up, because a lot of fairways these days are going to get used from the tee, particularly the distance that some of them go. And certainly I think that's where the Rogue really has an advantage. So I took all of them on the tee as well, and with the Epic it gained a few extra yards, but really this is where the Rogue took off, because the standard Rogue, you got an extra 4 yards on the Epic, and with the Sub-Zero you got an extra 8 yards. So that's where you can see that this lower spinning design, when you get the launch with it, when you tee it up, that's when it's really going to come into its own and you get that extra distance. And particularly with that Sub-Zero club, this one's a very good club. So if you wanted a driving fairway and you can, your swing suits this spin profile of the Sub-Zero, then I think that'd be the one to go for. If it's probably more general use, you're going to use it a bit more from the fairway and everything else is the same, then probably the standard Rogue is going to be a lot easier for that, because it's just going to be easier to get up in the air and get it going. There's a very wide range of lofts in this, because you've got the fixed hosels. You're going from a 13.5 degree 3 wood right up to a 25 degree 11 wood. There are some great clubs in there. They've got the Heavenwood back again, which is a 20 degree wood, but it has a 4 wood length shaft in it, and that is there combined to give you the launch but also the distance. And if you're looking for something like a strong 5 wood or even one that can sort of knock on the door the distance that a 3 wood can give you from the fairway, then that is definitely worth checking out. But really, with the whole range, there's a very comprehensive choice of lofts and I'm sure you're going to find one in there to suit you. In terms of price, I think it's right where it should be in the market. It's really going to go head to head with the TaylorMade M4 fairway, which is really the other one. And this is the battle I think I was wanting to see last year. I wanted to see the speed of M4 against the speed of a fairway from Callaway with a jailbreak in it. When I've had them out together, it's been very close indeed. So it's really going to come down to swing preference and shaft choice as to which one you might be able to go for. But it's going to be interesting to watch how that plays out in the market this year. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have, please drop some comments below. It'd be great to hear from you. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep in touch with all the videos we're launching. And for more reviews on all the Callaway equipment, just check out the golfalot.com website.